what can make or break your reputation as a homeopath. Patients come to us with the trust that we can handle their acute situations also. And frankly, acute situations are also great opportunities to find the deeper acting remedy for the patient. So therefore, we need to understand a few things about it. I will just summarize the main points. The first and most important thing is to not panic, because normally in acute situations everybody is panicking. So it's important for the homeopath to not panic and to keep his head very, very cool and observe what is happening. He has to observe if there is an exciting factor, how did it start, what is the current symptomatology, what is the current state of the patient, what are the current peculiarities, what happened in the days preceding the acute. In this way, by observation, by questioning, by the observation of the relatives, you can understand what is in that patient at that time, what is important. So the second important thing after saying don't panic is, I should say, don't just try to tide over that acute. Don't try to somehow or the other give relief, because you have to see that as an opportunity. The vital force is telling you that now I am asking for my medicine. So you have to answer that call with your patience and sincerity and faith in the fundamental principles of homeopathy, which is holism and individualism. When you do that, then you will see there are some possibilities. One possibility is that when you go in the depth of what is peculiar in the acute situation, you find the same remedy which the patient needed anyway. Another possibility is that he needs a different remedy during the acute situation. And the third possibility is that you actually find his remedy during the acute situation. And you should resist the temptation to use specific remedies or well-known remedies just because it is known to be good for this or that. And you should resist the temptation to prescribe quickly. You should just be there and wait and watch, and you can really do beautiful things that can have very long-term healing impact on the patient. So, as an illustration, I'll just tell you about a case which I saw many, many years ago. It was actually the son of my compounder, the man who makes the medicine. And he had two sons. One was, I think, about 6, one was about 8. And both of them developed fever at the same time. And what is interesting was that he first brought the younger guy to me, and I heard the history that this child went to school, he was rebuked by the teacher, he was scolded by the teacher, he developed some fear and panic kind of situation. He woke up at night shrieking. The next day he developed high temperature, and in this temperature also he was shouting and shrieking and wanting somebody close to him and holding on very tightly to somebody. So I gave him stramonium, and he did very well in 1 or 2 days, very good result. The fever, which was very high, came down, his infection subsided. And after like 3 4 days, the eldest child was brought with fever. And the interesting part was the history was the same. And another teacher scolded the child, and he got frightened, and he developed high fever. And I said, "Wow, this is so wonderful." I gave him stramonium too, and this boy just went from bad to worse, and became very, very dull, very, very quiet. He would stop eating, stop drinking, became somewhat delirious at some point. His vitality was really, really low. And then we did the testing, and we found that he had a very rare combination of both typhoid as well as malaria. I mean, in the same child. I mean, this was. So we had to admit him in the hospital because he needed intravenous fluids. And this was the time when I felt really, you see, that quick fix, you know, like applying the same what you saw in the earlier child to this child, it didn't work. Because obviously, this child's state demanded a completely different remedy, and we had to really understand what the state was asking for by going and observing very, very carefully. And together with another colleague, I went there, and we sat in the hospital. He was admitted in the homeopathic hospital. We sat in the hospital for nearly 2 hours, and we saw the child was completely collapsed. You know, he was weak, he couldn't even like open his eyes, and he was not eating, not drinking, and he had high temperature. But he was not saying anything, and he was not asking for any company. This was the interesting difference between the earlier child and this one. He was not shrieking, he was not shouting, he was not active, he was completely dull and completely collapsed. So firstly, we knew we needed a remedy that has dullness and collapse. No reaction, like he was not reacting. Even with the fear, with the teacher, he was not reacting. Everything was internalized, and simply his vitality was going down. Then we sat with the mother and with the aunt and with the grandmother. So what happened to this child after this teacher scolded? What was the prodrome of the fever? So he said, "Well, the child had a very interesting dream in which he saw that the walls of the house, the cupboards of the house, was just coming towards him, and it was like going to, you know, almost choke him like this." This is what he said: "Everything is coming to me, everything is coming, the walls are collapsing on me." And then he had another dream or a vision or a delirious state where he saw that there were two angels that were standing by the side of the bed, and they were fanning him using those pankha fans, you know, like this, very, very hard. Very interesting. So now we had to find a remedy. The state was saying there is no reaction, there is dullness, there is collapse. And the delusion was that the walls were collapsing. And the other delusion was fanning, a lot of fanning. So when you now check the rubric, delusion, walls collapsing, you find carbovegetabilis, which is a great remedy that desires fanning. And it's the main remedy you think of in dullness and collapse. So these things, elements came together, and we gave him carbovegetabilis 1 m, I think it was. And I think it was one of those really amazing quick results that I saw, that within the next 2 days, this boy actually got up and walked out of the hospital, recovered completely. I mean, people who saw him couldn't believe that this happened. So these kind of results are very, very possible. And also what happened with this boy was that he was normally a very dull child who didn't study properly, who wouldn't understand properly, who was always lethargic, weak, not very active. But after this fever and after the carbo wedge, it's as if his whole constitution changed. And I'm really very happy to say that this boy grew up, studied very well. Now he's become an engineer, and I mean, he's doing amazingly beautifully. So this kind of patience and observation and going into the exciting factor, the prodrome, the peculiarities, the state, the overall state, the mental symptoms, the peculiar symptoms, the cravings, the aversions, all of this will give us a kind of a synergetic approach to the case. All these elements have to be taken into account to locate the remedy. And when you do that, you can see that the acute crisis is often the best thing to treat, because that's where the symptoms of the state are loudest and clearest. In a chronic condition, it's like a little bit hidden. But in an acute, it's all out there, you know, how the patient thinks, moves, walks, talks, eats, drinks. So I would conclude by saying that an acute situation is not one that you have to panic, or that you have to make a quick prescription, or that you have to somehow, you know, save yourself from this or whatever it is, and somehow tide over. But it's a situation where if you are observant and if you are having faith in the fundamental principles of holism and individualism, you have to just be there, and the state will come to you. It will present itself to you very nicely, and when you treat, not only you get good results for that moment, but you find that the overall health of the patient in the long run can improve significantly. So I would say use this acute as a great opportunity.
So we have few questions from the live audience.
Yeah.
One of the question is the importance to take allopathy medicine in emergency cases like myocardial infarct.
Well, yes, normally in myocardial infarction, care unit, and you cannot stop them from taking So I guess that in a way one has to be also a little bit practical, because myocardial infarction, for example, has a high risk of, you know, patient losing his life, whether with or without allopathy. They say the first 24 hours are crucial, you know, you can lose your life. So in such a situation, if you want to be in a way not take any chances, you can go with that. And especially since a homeopathic hospital does not have intensive cardiac care units, it's very difficult to control or regulate a patient only on homeopathic treatment.
Thank you for your time, sir. To watch more videos from Dr. Shankaran, you can log on to hope.synergyhomeopathic.com. Thank you, sir.